So good morning, the world. Good morning, Barbara and Marion and William. And how nice to see Barbara here in Berkeley. So if someone could tell me if they hear the sound, that would be great. So good morning, everyone. And I see that the label of the live stream today is called Happy Hour. That's left over from yesterday afternoon's Happy Hour at IMC, and it wasn't changed back. But it's delighted that we could also call this Happy Hour, our time together. And as an introduction to this guided meditation, and I would like to say that Buddhism has a lot to do with cultivating wisdom and cultivating compassion. Wisdom and compassion are called sometimes the two wings of the bird of Buddhism that keeps it flying. And there's one quality that I want to emphasize that is a great support for both wisdom and compassion, and that is tranquility or calm. The more we need wisdom, the more important it is to be calm. The more we need compassion, the more important it is to be calm or settled. Agitation, stress is the, disrupts our capacity for wisdom and for compassion. And for now, the with what is happening in the wider world, the distress the people have, the challenges people have, the tremendous uncertainty of what's coming for so many of us, is a time for tremendous amount of wisdom and compassion. And as we sit here this morning together, my hope is that whatever calm that we are able to acquire or settle into, that we understand that we're doing it so that we can become wise, so that we become compassionate, that our meditation is not independent of what's happening in the wider world, but it's to help us become the kind of people that somehow can contribute to greater peace and well-being and safety for everyone. So, and I see there's one chat from UK saying it's good afternoon there. So, good afternoon, the whole world. Good evening, or it's evening, and good morning here in California. So, to sit, take a meditation posture that expresses for you some sense of purpose, the purpose of being alert, aware, and within that, or with that, to become tranquil. And this combination of tranquil and alert, alert and tranquil. And we begin, some of that's discovered through the body. And to be careful and caring with the posture you're in, so that the posture can support a deep relaxation. If we're slumped in the couch, it might be relaxing in the short term, but it doesn't allow for the deepest possible relaxation. I once read a study that said that the two postures allow for the deepest relaxation is the cross-legged meditation posture and lying completely flat on the floor on one's back. And gently closing your eyes. And with, maybe with love or care or kind regard for yourself, let your attention wander around your body caringly to find the places in the body that you can tend to, care for, by gentle relaxation, softening. Perhaps if you soften the belly, letting the belly hang forward, you can feel the weight of the body settle a little bit further down. Softening the chest, relaxing the shoulders, and softening the muscles of the face. And then to bring your care and attention of kind regard to the experience of the body breathing. To do so less with a purpose of accomplishing something with attention to the breathing, but more an attention that is the vehicle for your care, for your kindness, for this body of yours. This body that breathes. And perhaps there can be a gentling of your breath. A feeling of tenderness to the body breathing. And as you exhale, to let go. Of your thinking. And even if the letting go is temporary, for the next little while, every time you exhale, see if you can soften, quiet, or let go of what you're thinking. As you exhale, letting go of your thoughts and letting go into a quiet or a calm within your body. And for the purposes of becoming tranquil, it's useful to soften, relax the thinking muscle. Any tension or pressure, contraction, agitation associated with thinking. The more pressure or tension there is associated with thinking, the more forceful the thinking will be. The thinking muscle is sometimes felt behind the forehead, center of the brain, sometimes muscles of the face, or even the shoulders and the belly sometimes is where the tension is, the chest. Whatever tension you associate with thinking. See if you can let it relax. Allow it to melt away. noticing wherever you are feeling agitated or not calm. Whatever agitation you might feel, however subtle, hold that gently in awareness. If you can, avoid seeing it as a problem, but as something to hold in the warmth of your open palms of awareness. Care for it, caring attention. Making space for it to begin to soften or melt by itself. Bringing a calm attention to that part of you that is not calm. As you exhale, softening the whole body, as you inhale, see if you can brighten the alertness. As you inhale, a greater clarity of attention in the body. And as you inhale and exhale, softening as you exhale, and being a little brighter with your attention as you inhale, and gently going back and forth, softening and being alert, relaxing and being bright with attention. And then as we come to the end of this sitting, you might reflect for a few moments on two questions. As you consider how you feel right now, how you are at the end of the meditation, what wisdom perspective do you have for how you will live the day? How you would like to live this day, or if it's nighttime for you, tomorrow. And with whatever calm or subtleness you might have, how can you live this day with more compassion, kindness, care?